Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today we will discuss the dorsum of foot. See here in this diagram, this is the dorsum of foot or dorsal surface of foot. First of all, the skin. The skin on the dorsum of foot is thin, hairy and freely mobile on the underlying tendons and bones. This is much like the condition in the dorsum of hand. The cutaneous nerves which are supplying the dorsum of foot. The sensory nerve supply to the skin on the dorsum of foot is derived from four nerves. Number one, superficial peroneal nerve. Number two, deep peroneal nerve. Number three, sural nerve. And number four, saphenous nerve. Most of the skin on the dorsum of the foot is supplied by superficial peroneal nerve. This superficial peroneal nerve is a branch of common peroneal nerve, and this is the main nerve of the lateral compartment of leg. It has a root value L4 to S1. It supplies most of the skin on the dorsum of the foot, which includes the medial part of the big toe and the adjacent sides of the second, third, fourth, and fifth toes, and most of the skin on the dorsal surface of the foot. Number two is deep peroneal nerve, which is also a branch of the common peroneal nerve, is having the root value L4 and L5, and it is the main nerve of the anterior compartment of leg. It supplies the cleft between the big toe and the second toe in the dorsum of the foot. Then we have the saphenous nerve, which is the root having root value L3 and L4, and it is the branch of the femoral nerve. It supplies the medial side of the dorsum of the foot. It passes in front of the medial malleolus and it supplies the medial surface of the dorsum of the foot up till the head of the first metatarsal. See here in this diagram, at this point up till the head of the first metatarsal is present. So up till this point, the saphenous nerve is supplying the dorsum of the foot. Then we have the sural nerve. Sural nerve is having the root value S1 and S2. This sural nerve is formed by the combination of two sural nerves. One is medial sural cutaneous nerve and one is lateral sural cutaneous nerve. Medial sural cutaneous nerve is a branch of tibial nerve and the lateral sural cutaneous nerve is a branch of common peroneal nerve. Both sural nerves coming from tibial and common peroneal nerves, they join together to form a main sural nerve which supplies the lateral part of the dorsum of the foot and the lateral surface of the little toe. So these are four nerves which are supplying the dorsum of the foot. The superficial peroneal nerve emerges from between the fibularis brevis and extensor digitorum longus muscle in the lower part of the leg. It divides into medial and lateral cutaneous branches that supplies the skin on the dorsum of the foot, the medial side of the big toe, and the adjacent sides of the second, third, fourth, and fifth toes. The deep peroneal nerve supplies the skin of the adjacent sides of big and second toe, as I have shown you in this figure. This is the adjacent side of big toe and the second toe, which is supplied by deep peroneal nerve. The saphenous nerve, which is the branch of the femoral nerve, passes on the dorsum of the foot in front of the medial malleolus of the tibia. It supplies the skin on the medial side of the foot as far forward as the head of the first metatarsal bone. The sural nerve enters the foot behind the lateral malleolus and supplies the skin along the lateral margin of the foot and the lateral side of the little toe, as I have shown you in this diagram. This is the sural nerve which is supplying the lateral side of the little toe. The medial and the lateral plantar nerves, which are the nerves of the sole of the foot. Medial and the lateral plantar nerve, they are the branches of the tibial nerve. They supply the nail beds and skin covering the dorsal surfaces of the terminal phalanges. See here in this diagram, these are the nail beds and these are the dorsal surfaces of the terminal phalanges. Two two-third is supplied by the medial plantar nerve and one-third is supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. Medial two-third by medial plantar, which is a branch of tibial nerve, and lateral one-third by the lateral plantar, which is also a terminal branch of the tibial nerve. So we have discussed the cutaneous nerves on the dorsum of the foot. Mainly we have four nerves. One is superficial peroneal, one is deep peroneal, one is saphenous nerve, one is sural nerve. But along these four nerves, two other nerves which are supplying the sole of foot, which are medial plantar and lateral plantar, they also supply the terminal phalanges and the nail beds. Now I will explain you the branches of the sciatic nerve. See here, this is sciatic nerve, which is having the root value L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3, and it is a branch of sacral plexus. This sciatic nerve is present in the posterior compartment of thigh, and it is divided in the gluteal region into two nerves. One is medial nerve, which is tibial nerve, and one is common peroneal nerve, which is lateral nerve. In this slide, I will discuss the common peroneal nerve, which is also called as the common fibular nerve. It is present in the back of the thigh, and in the back of the thigh it supplies only one muscle, which is the short head of the biceps femoris muscle. Short head of the biceps femoris muscle, which is the muscle of the back of thigh. When it reaches the knee joint, it supplies the knee joint. Okay, and in the lateral compartment of leg, it divides into two branches. One is superficial peroneal and one is deep peroneal. Superficial peroneal, which is also called as superficial fibular, and deep peroneal, which is also called as deep fibular nerve. The superficial fibular nerve is the nerve of the lateral compartment of leg, and the deep peroneal nerve is the nerve of the anterior compartment of leg. Along with these two nerves, it also gives a sural communicating branch, which I have told you the common fibular nerve will give the lateral sural cutaneous nerve, which will supply the skin of the lateral side of the leg, and when it reaches the foot, it supplies the lateral side of the foot and the little toe. Okay, it supplies, because this is the main branch of the common fibular nerve. This is the sural nerve, which is supplying the lateral side of the foot and the little toe. Okay, now we will discuss the deep peroneal nerve first. Deep peroneal nerve is a branch of the common peroneal, which is the nerve of the anterior compartment of leg. So the muscles of the anterior compartment of leg are supplied by deep peroneal. They are tibialis anterior, extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus, and peroneus tertius. When it reaches the ankle joint, it will supply the ankle joint. Okay, now the superficial peroneal nerve, this is the nerve of the lateral compartment of leg. So it supplies the muscles of the lateral compartment of leg, which are fibularis longus muscle or the peroneus longus, and fibularis brevis or the peroneus brevis muscle. It also supplies the skin of the leg. Okay, then when they reaches the foot, the deep peroneal nerve will supply the muscle of the anterior compartment or muscle of the dorsum of the foot, which is a single muscle, which is extensor digitorum brevis muscle. Extensor digitorum brevis muscle, which we will discuss in this lecture. This is the muscle of the dorsum of the foot, and it supplies the skin of the cleft between the first and the second toe in the dorsum of the foot. The superficial peroneal nerve, when reaches the dorsum of the foot, it supplies the skin of the foot, the medial side of the big toe, the adjacent sides of the second, third, fourth and the little toe, and it supplies most of the skin of the dorsum of the foot. Now I will describe the tibial nerve. Tibial nerve is also a branch of the sciatic nerve, which is a branch of the sacral plexus. Tibial nerve is present medially. It supplies the hip joint and it comes in the posterior compartment of thigh. Tibial nerve is the main nerve, which is supplying all muscles of the back of the thigh except the short head of the biceps femoris, which was supplied by the common peroneal nerve. So the tibial nerve is supplied the semitendinosus, semimembranosus, and the long head of the biceps femoris muscle, which are the muscles of the back of the thigh. Okay, they will supply, it will supply all these muscles, and it will also supply the hamstring part of the adductor magnus muscle. Adductor magnus muscle is a muscle of the medial compartment of thigh, but its hamstring part, which is coming posteriorly, is also supplied by the tibial nerve. When it reaches the knee joint, it will supply the knee joint because it is crossing. This is a rule that if any nerve is crossing a joint, it will supply that joint. For example, if because it crossing the hip joint, so it supplies the hip joint. When it crosses the knee joint, it will supply the knee joint. When it crosses the ankle joint, so it will supply the ankle joint. Now it will come in the leg. Okay, the tibial nerve is the main nerve of the posterior compartment of leg. Okay, the common peroneal nerve, which was the other branch, it was the branch of the anterior and the lateral compartment of leg, because it gives two branches, superficial peroneal and deep peroneal. Deep peroneal supplies the anterior compartment of leg, superficial peroneal supplies the lateral compartment of leg. So the deep tibial nerve will supply the posterior compartment of leg. So all muscles which are gastrocnemius, soleus, plantaris, popliteus, tibialis posterior, flexor digitorum longus, flexor hallucis longus, all superficial and deep muscles of the posterior compartment of leg are supplied by tibial nerve. Then it will supply the ankle joint, and it will give a sural medial cutaneous nerve, which will supply the lateral side of the dorsum of the foot, along with the sural lateral cutaneous nerve, which is the branch of the common peroneal nerve. Then this tibial nerve is divided into two branches, which I have already told you, medial plantar nerve and the lateral plantar nerve. From the name, it is obvious that it is supplying the plantar surface, which is opposite of the dorsal surface, which is the sole of the foot. So it supplies the sole of the foot or the plantar surface of the foot. One is medial plantar and one is lateral plantar. From the name, it is obvious that medial plantar will supply the skin of the medial two-third of the sole of the foot, and the lateral plantar will supply the skin of the lateral one-third of the sole of the foot. It will also supply some muscles. There are four layers of muscles in the sole of foot. Out of those four layers, some muscles are supplied by medial plantar, for example the first layer and the first lumbrical muscle, and all other layers and introsci and all other layer muscles, they are supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. Medial plantar will supply the abductor hallucis, flexor digitorum brevis, flexor hallucis brevis. They are present in the first layer and the second layer and first lumbrical also. The lateral plantar will supply the flexor digitorum accessorius, the abductor digiti minimi, flexor digiti minimi brevis, second, third and fourth lumbrical, and adductor hallucis and all introsci. So these are the branches of the tibial nerve. Now we will see that what is the venous drainage of the dorsum of the foot. The great part of the blood from the whole foot drains in the dorsal venous arch via the digital veins and the communicating veins from the sole, which pass through the introsseous spaces. The dorsal venous arch lies in the subcutaneous tissue over the head of the metatarsals. It drains on the medial side into the great saphenous vein and on the lateral side into the small saphenous vein. The great saphenous vein leaves the dorsum of the foot by ascending in the leg in front of the medial malleolus, and the small saphenous vein ascend in the leg behind the lateral malleolus. Remember this thing, that dorsal venous arch is present in the subcutaneous tissue over the head of the metatarsals, and it will drain in the great saphenous vein on the lateral medial side and the small saphenous vein on the lateral side. Now, one muscle which is present in the dorsum of the foot is extensor digitorum brevis muscle. See here, this is extensor digitorum brevis muscle. It is originated from the anterior part of the upper surface of the calcaneum and from the inferior extensor retinaculum. It is divided into four tendons, and which are inserted into the proximal phalanx of the big toe and the long extensor tendons to the second, third and the fourth toe. See here, one tendon is inserted in the big toe, and second, third, and fourth toes have the tendons of the extensor digitorum brevis. The extensor digitorum brevis is not inserted on the little toe. This is the sole intrinsic muscle on the dorsum of the foot. It is supplied by deep peroneal nerve. It extends the toes. Okay, the muscle sent a long tendon to the big toe. This tendon is a part of the extensor digitorum brevis because it is inserted over the big toe, so it is named as extensor hallucis brevis. But there is no tendon which run to the fifth digit. Remember this thing again. I will explain. Extensor digitorum brevis is a sole intrinsic muscle on the dorsum of the foot, which is supplied by deep peroneal nerve. It is having one tendon which is inserted over the big toe. That's why that part of the extensor digitorum brevis is named as extensor hallucis brevis, and it is not inserted on the little toe. See here, these are the long extensor tendons which are inserted on the dorsum of the foot. One is peroneus tertius. See here, this is peroneus tertius muscle. This one is peroneus tertius, and these are the extensor digitorum longus muscle. Extensor digitorum longus muscle along with extensor, this is extensor digitorum brevis muscle. The tendon of the extensor digitorum longus passes deep to the extensor superior extensor retinaculum and through the inferior extensor retinaculum along with the peroneus tertius muscle. Again, I will explain. The extensor digitorum longus tendons, they pass deep to the superior extensor retinaculum and inferior extensor retinaculum and along with the peroneus tertius muscle. The tendon divide into four slips, okay, which fan out over the dorsum of the foot and pass to the lateral four toes. See here, it is passing to the lateral four toes. This is the lateral fifth toe, this is fourth, this is third, and this is second one. So these are lateral toes. Opposite the metatarsophalangeal joint of the second, third, and the fourth toe, each tendon of the extensor digitorum longus, it is joined on its lateral side by a tendon of the extensor digitorum brevis muscle. See here, this is the tendon of the extensor digitorum brevis, this is the tendon of the extensor digitorum brevis, and this is the tendon of the extensor digitorum brevis. So laterally, the extensor digitorum longus muscle, they are having a tendon, or tendons are joined on its lateral side. Those tendons are of the extensor digitorum brevis muscle. This muscle, which is the main muscle of the dorsum of the foot, they are joining, or they are giving tendons which are joined to the extensor digitorum longus tendons. On the dorsal surface of each toe, the extensor tendon join the facial expansion, which is called as extensor dorsal expansion. This is extensor dorsal expansion. Near the proximal interphalangeal joint, see here, this is proximal interphalangeal joint, this is also proximal interphalangeal joint, the extensor expansion split into three parts. See here, it is splitting into three parts. A central part which is inserted in the base of the middle phalanx, and two lateral parts which are converging and they are inserting into the base of the distal phalanx. Again, I will explain. See here, extensor digitorum longus tendons along with the peroneus tertius muscle, they are passing deep to the extensor retinacula. When they come on the main side or the dorsum of the foot, the second tendon, third, and fourth tendon, they are joined by the tendons of the extensor digitorum brevis muscle, okay, on its lateral side. Then these five tendons, when they reach the proximal interphalangeal joint, they split, they are forming the extensor expansion, which split into three parts. The central part is inserted over the middle phalanx, and two lateral parts are inserted over the base of the distal phalanx. The extensor expansion, as in the fingers, receive the insertion of the introcii muscle and the lumbrical muscle. See here, these are the introcii muscle which are inserted or which are attached to the tendons of the extensor expansion. Now the dorsum arterial supply, which is the main artery which is supplying the dorsum of the foot. Remember one thing, that there is one dorsalis pedis artery. Dorsalis means the dorsal surface, pedis is the foot. So this is the artery which is supplying the dorsal surface of the foot. It is the continuation of the anterior tibial artery. See here in this diagram, this is anterior tibial artery and it is giving one artery which is named as dorsalis pedis artery, which will supply the dorsum of the foot. It begins in front of the ankle joint at an imaginary line which is joining the medial malleolus of the tibia and the lateral malleolus of the fibula. It is superficial in position and it is crossed by the inferior extensor retinaculum and the first tendon of the extensor digitorum brevis muscle. See here, it is crossed by the first tendon. This is the first tendon of the extensor digitorum brevis muscle. So it is crossed by this muscle. On its lateral side, you can see here the terminal part of the common fibular nerve and the starting point of the deep, this is the terminal part of the deep peroneal nerve, okay, which is the branch of the common peroneal, is present on the lateral side of the dorsalis pedis artery along with the extensor digitorum longus muscles, or all tendons of the extensor digitorum longus muscle. On the medial side lies the tendon of the extensor hallucis longus. This is the medial side of the dorsalis pedis artery. Here the tendon of the extensor hallucis longus is present. Its pulsation can easily be felt in this location. The vessel terminates. See here, this vessel, which is the dorsalis pedis artery, it is terminating by passing into the sole, where it joins the lateral plantar artery and completes the plantar arch. So in exam they can ask you how the plantar arch is formed. So it is formed by the anastomosis between two arteries. One is dorsalis pedis artery, which is the continuation of the anterior tibial artery, and one is lateral plantar artery, which is the branch of the posterior tibial artery, and it is supplying the sole of the foot. So this was the dorsum arterial supply, which is the dorsalis pedis artery, which is also named as dorsal artery of the foot. The dorsal artery of the foot or the dorsalis pedis artery give many branches. First branch is the lateral tarsal artery. This lateral tarsal artery crosses the dorsum of the foot just below the ankle joint. Then there is arcuate artery. See here, this is arcuate artery, which runs laterally deep to the extensor tendons opposite the base of the metatarsal bones. This arcuate artery gives off many metatarsal branches to the toes. Then there is first dorsal metatarsal artery. This is first dorsal metatarsal artery, which supply both sides of the big toe. This is supplying the medial side of the big toe and the lateral side of the big toe. See here, this is the first dorsal metatarsal artery. Then there is deep plantar artery. Okay, this deep plantar artery actually anastomoses with the lateral plantar artery and forms the plantar arterial arch. See here, the deep plantar artery, which is the terminal branch of the dorsalis pedis artery, divides and it goes into the sole between the two head of the first interosseous muscle. It anastomoses with the lateral plantar artery to complete the plantar arterial arch or the plantar arch. So these are the branches of the dorsalis pedis artery. Number one is lateral tarsal, number two is arcuate, number three is first dorsal metatarsal artery, which is supplying big toe, and number four is deep plantar artery, which is anastomosing with the lateral plantar artery to form the plantar arch. Now the dorsum nerve supply. See here, the deep peroneal nerve, which is present on the lateral side of the anterior tibial artery and the dorsalis pedis artery, it enters the dorsum of the foot by passing deep to the extensor retinaculum on the lateral side of the dorsalis pedis artery. It divides into terminal, medial and lateral branches. There are medial branches and the lateral branches of the deep peroneal nerve. The medial branch, which is shown here in this diagram, This medial branch supplies the adjacent sides of the big and the second toe. See here, it is supplying the adjacent side of the big toe and the second toe. As I have already told you that the deperoneal nerve supplies only this part of the dorsum of the foot. All other parts or all other surface of the dorsum of the foot is supplied by superficial peroneal, sural nerve and the saphenous nerve. So only the cleft between the big toe and the second toe is supplied by the deperoneal nerve. The lateral branch will supply the extensor digitorum brevis muscle, which is the only muscle of the dorsum of the foot. So which is supplied by lateral branch of the deperoneal nerve. Both these terminal branches give articular branch to the joints of the foot. Because they are crossing the joints of the foot, so they will supply the joints of the foot.